Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Hope you are having a great start to your week. Sorry if I sound kind of funny, the allergies in where I live are getting out of control and I'm a little bit puffy and sound a little bit nasally, but hey, we gotta make the content for the channel, right? Well, let's get into this. Apparently the Days Gone writer says, if you love a game, you should buy it at full price. Don't complain if a game doesn't get a sequel if it wasn't supported at launch. And man, oh man, Ashevitz, is this a hot take if I've ever seen one. My first response to this is, how do you know you love a game if you've never even played it? And then you want to go and buy it full price day one. Which, of course, completely destroys this argument, because the only way you would love a game before you even bought it or played it is if you were just super whelmed up into the hype train and didn't even bother to actually look at any previews, reviews, or anything like that. So we're already off to a phenomenally bad start. But let's continue with the article from Eurogamer. The writer and creative director of Days Gone says that players shouldn't complain if a game doesn't get a sequel if they didn't buy it at full price. How about this? F you. That's my response to you, because games costing $70 shouldn't. And games being launched buggy and riddled and broken shouldn't. Because if I'm going to give you $70 at day one, the game should be feature complete and work. I gave you my entire $70. You gave me a broken, buggy, incomplete game. Sit on that one and spin for a little bit. In an interview with David Jaffe's YouTube channel, John Garvin was asked if the game's debut on Sony PlayStation Plus subscription service had sparked new interest in the title. He then continues to say, I do have an opinion on something that your audience may find of interest, and it might piss some of them off. Gavin said, if you love a game, buy it at full price. I can't tell you how many times I've seen gamers say, yeah, I got that on sale. I got it through PS Plus. Whatever. Immediately, like I said before, my first response is, how do you know you love a game if you've never played it? And it's the first time you're playing it and you bought it at full price. You are literally going into the don't ask questions, just consume product and get excited for next product timeline. This is the most ridiculous thing you could ever ask anyone to do. And even then, putting the onus onto the consumer to make them responsible for the sequel because they didn't buy the game in a specific timeline for a specific price is absolute shit, and you know it. He then continues his statements by saying, don't complain if a game doesn't get a sequel if it wasn't supported at launch, Gavin added. It's like God of War got whatever number millions of sales at launch. And you know, Days Gone didn't. It's because Days Gone was a buggy riddled game. That's why. Just speaking for me personally as a developer, I don't work for Sony. I don't know what the numbers are. Gavin then also opened up on the impact piracy has on game development. I can tell you that when we were doing Siphon Filter Dark Mirror on PSP, we got so f***ed on Dark Mirror because piracy was a thing. It's still a thing. And Sony wasn't really caught up on what piracy was doing to sales, Gavin explained. And we would show them torrents, and a torrent site had 200,000 copies of Dark Mirror being downloaded. If I remember it right, the numbers could be wrong, but regardless, I was pissed about it then. I was like, this is money out of my pocket. So I think the uptick in engagement with the game is not as important as, did you buy the game at full price? Because if you did, then that's supporting the developers directly. No, no, this isn't about support the developers. This isn't about like, oh, money out of your pocket. So look, we can talk about piracy a whole other time because that's a whole other conversation. My argument right now is the fact that he wants people to buy a game full price that they've never played. And even in nowadays, games do not come feature complete. They come half built, half broken, half buggy, half complete. And then they want you to go ahead and buy more expansions and season passes and it on top of the game. So a $70 game that you bought day one now costs you upwards of $100 or more because you want to get everything else. Or you can be the smart consumer and say, I'm going to wait the year. I'm going to buy the game of the year collection. I'm going to get everything feature complete. I'm going to get the game fully patched. It's going to work functionally well. It's going to be the way the game was designed to be played on the day of release a year later. And I'm only going to spend $60 or maybe even less. That's the issue right here. The thing is, what Garvin doesn't understand is that he's no longer thinking like someone who has to buy video games. He's thinking like someone who has the disposable income to actually go off and do it themselves. A lot of people, even nowadays, don't have that kind of income anymore. And even before everything that happened this last year, people were still scrapping for cash. You don't go out and force people and put the onus on people to buy games day one if they want a sequel of a game they never even played yet. But you want them to go out and spend $70 to $100 on a video game? Day one? Are you out of your mind? And not even knowing if it's broken, never seeing the game, only seeing the marketing material. This guy's so out of touch with what gamers actually deal with on a daily basis. And even then, the way he said it is the actual issue, not even what he said. It could have been said a much different way. Garvin could have easily said something like this. Hey, look, you know, one of the big things that a lot of publishers look for is how the game sells from its initial launch and a specific time window. The best way to support the actual game and developers is if you can, to actually go out and buy the game day one. We know not everybody can because times are hard for everybody and everybody's in different situations. But if you want to support the game, if you want to support the devs, it's a nice thing to do. If you can go out and buy the game day one, it'd be great. If you can't, you know what? Support the game whenever you can, but it's nice to have that there. And we can use those sales to pitch our next sequel for that game. And hopefully it gets greenlit. Boom. There you go. I should be your PR for Sony. But Garvin, the unbelievable actual assumption that you have to force people to put the onus on top of them in order to go out and then make them responsible for the sequel, not you and your studio, not how you pitched Days Gone 2, not what you guys actually did, and the fact that you guys went through and launched a broken, buggy game on day of release and it didn't only get the support it needed until recently, and you want people to spend $70 in full price, day and date, or even in a specific time window for that game? No, dude. Guess what? You. The horse you rode in on, because that's it, and you shouldn't be saying that to people. This is why people get so pissed off at video game companies nowadays, because when they see the transparency and they see the it, they understand, like, oh, you're just trying to me. You just want to get into my wallet, and that's exactly what they're trying to do. That's what every publisher and developer is trying to do. They don't see you as consumers and customers and things like that. They see you as open wallets to open up and try and squeeze out every single bread cent that they can out of your pocket. And you know what? I'm sick of it, and you should be sick of it too. Because so many games nowadays treat you like cattle, like wallets being fed to the slaughter. And honestly, I'm not going to take it anymore. If you think a game is good, and if you're excited for a game, wait for the review. See if you like the game. Watch a live Let's Play of it. Watch a Twitch streamer of it. Watch somebody play it live and see if maybe you're going to be interested in that game even after you see some of the mechanics. Because even then, a lot of the gaming media is just force-fed marketing. And then decide what you want to spend your hard-earned money on. Because if you're working a minimum wage job, or even if you're making 15 bucks an hour, if you're making that kind of money, it costs you 4 hours of your job to actually pay for that game if it's $60. It costs you 5 hours out of your day to pay for that game if it's $70 or around that price. Don't forget DLC, season passes, and microtransactions. But that's the issue. It costs too much money for video games to buy them nowadays. And to have somebody go out and say, buy the game day and date full price if you want to get a sequel is bad. So I went off on a little bit of a rant there, and I'm sorry, but let me know what you guys think in the comments section down below. Do you agree with me, or do you think Garvin actually has a point? I'd like to find out and talk about that, so let me know in the comment section down below, like I said before. If you like the content, please subscribe to the channel. It does mean a lot. I really do appreciate it. And if you want to check me out on Twitch and Twitter, you absolutely can. It's at, oh no, it's Alex. Join the Discord. The link is in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate everyone. Hope you guys have a great one, and I'll see you next time. Bullshit, Hulk Hogan!